So we now have defined a very simple system, like in the on the screen in the notes. We have a single process generating elements, the user arrival one, and a single service processing these elements and then spitting them out. Just now we have 100 iterations, and we only have one element in the queue, and 50 elements have been processed, 50 items have been processed. The user arrival generator, as you can expect from all the generators, has a utilization of 100%. That's gonna be true all the time, unless you're applying some sort of back pressure in the on the queue that the generator pushes to. And then on the other side, the service is processing items with a 73% utilization rate, which is very interesting. It tells you that we could be generating more users, and the service we have would be able to cope with the extra load without producing a longer queue on the input of the service. And as you can see here, after 100 iterations, the length of the queue outside, just outside the generation of the user, is just one, which is great. I can also try and increase the number of iteration, and ideally the result is going to be very similar. We have 500 pieces being produced, or like users being processed, being serviced, and 75% is the utilization rate of the service. I want to show you something. This is what happens if we, let me just reduce this again, make this smaller because we're not interested at the moment. Let me check what happens if we go and tweak the generators for the two distributions, for the two generator and service. For example, what do you think will happen if we start generating more users? For example, if we reduce the arrival rate from 1 to 3 seconds to 1 to 2 seconds. Well, the expectation is that the utilization rate of the service is going to go up, and potentially we might start at some point seeing the queue length outside of the generator to be higher than 0 and higher than 1. So if I simulate for 100 times, we can see that the queue is now 2, so we have a slightly higher queue, and the service is a 98.5% utilization rate. What this tells us is that we're very close to breaking point. If we increase the rate at which users get to the service, then we're going to start building up a queue that is not going to be necessarily handled by the service in a timely fashion. And that's the beauty of this sort of simulation. We don't have to have an analytical mathematical formulation of the problem. We can discover things about the real world by modeling them in a very simple fashion, and simulating the scenarios we have in mind with different setups possibly, right? So what happens if I take this down a bit further and say that the arrival rate is between 1 and 1.5? Again, the expectation is the service utilization is going to be 100%, and the user arrival generator will be starting to enqueue, will start to enqueue elements in Q1, and so this number here is going to go up, possibly even quite dramatically, if the number of generated items is too high. So I'm going to simulate again, and here you go. You have a 100% service utilization, which is expected, and 64 pieces have been produced after 100 iterations. We don't seem to be able to do any better than this. And but as you can see, we're starting to build up a queue on the user side. So users come in, and then you have to queue. They have to queue for a while, and then at some point they will be served. But the thinking here is, if I want this to be modeling a real life scenario, should I be concerned about the fact that a queue is building up over time? And the answer is, well, the only way to figure out is to extend the length of the simulation and see if this behavior is divergent to some extent, in the sense that we are going had to have a queue that grows and grows without ever shrinking, or if that 15 people in the queue is just a fluke due to the probabilistic nature, the stochastic nature of our simulation, and then over time that queue is going to be taken care of. We can run a simulation with 200 iterations rather than 100 and see if the queue size goes up again. It does indeed, it doubled, so we seem to be able to predict that every 100 iterations the number of people in the queue is going to increase, which is not doesn't look great. And so if we're simulating a cinema or a factory and we want to know what we should do next, a possibility would be to add an extra service to our system. So I'm going to be calling this service 1. And the idea is, well, if we can add another node that that takes care of handling requests, then this extra node can take some of the load out of the other service. We can have the utilization of the of service 1 is going to go down a bit, but at least we're going to be managing to keeping the queue to keep the queue quite short or even equal to zero in size. So in this setup, for example, we can imagine we have another service, but we can pretend the service is a bit slower, so we can say that it takes from 2 to 3 times to serve customers with this second service. You can see that the input is the same. We just added an extra activity on the like in parallel, and so the scenario is this: if we wanted to go crazy in a bit of ASCII art, and if we simulate our system now, we should expect to see a lower utilization of service 1 and a higher throughput. So overall, so we expect to see more than 130 elements being processed, but also we expect the queue size to be shorter. Let's launch a simulation. Sorry, I need to remember to add the service to our simulation, to our set of nodes. Fantastic. So we have 2 services being used. Let me remove the extra space here. For 77, 72%, around 7% utilization, 150 elements processed by each, and the queue size on the user arrival now is 1, which means it's like it's going to be very, very small, if not 0 all the time, which is exactly what we wanted. Okay, so let's try and build a slightly more complicated system now.